I'm Adina Roskies. I'm the Hellman Family Distinguished Professor at Dartmouth College. I'm a professor of philosophy and the chair of the Cognitive Science Program at Dartmouth College. And this year, I'm at the University of Pittsburgh. I'm the senior fellow at the Center for Philosophy of Science, which has been a pleasure. I get to talk to other philosophers of science, and I get to do my own work for a change. The areas that I'm interested in are philosophy of mind, philosophy of science, and in particular the philosophy of neuroscience and cognitive science, and also in ethics, and again with a focus on ethics and moral psychology. So in essence, what I'm interested in are the kinds of questions that lie at the intersection of our understanding of mind and brain and ethics. So philosophical and neuroscientific kinds of questions and where they come together. In particular, one of my projects is on the philosophy of free will, the problem of free will. And I focus on the questions of what neuroscience can and cannot say about the problem of free will. So that's a very long-standing philosophical problem, and many people have argued that more recently, because of advances in neuroscience, we can begin to answer this problem, or in some people think that we have answered this problem and have ruled out the possibility of free will. So I look carefully at the kind of experiments that people say have a bearing on the problem of free will, and in fact I've concluded that in fact none of the existing experiments, including the very famous Libet experiment, succeeds in undermining the notion that we have free will. Moreover, I've gone on to argue that there are no possible neuroscientific experiments that can rule out the possibility of free will. A related project that I'm interested in is the problem of self-control. So how is it that we as physical systems can be said to control ourselves? And so this is another intersection of neuroscientific and cognitive scientific work with philosophical questions. A second project that I'm working on this year is the problem of agency, and in particular, I am trying to measure agency. So I have an NIH grant funded by the Brain Initiative to develop a diagnostic tool for measuring agency. We're trying to make an online tool that uses survey and behavioral measures in order to determine sort of the picture of a certain person's agency. And using machine learning techniques, we then try to, on the basis of lots of data, build up a picture of what kinds of profiles different kinds of agentive diseases or deficiencies have. And the point of this project is to apply this tool in order to describe the kinds of changes to agency that we see in different kinds of neural interventions. Our project in particular focuses on deep brain stimulation, but in theory you could use this tool to explore the effects of neural interventions through pharmacology or even brain-computer interfaces. And so this is going to be an essential descriptive part of the neuroethical analysis of brain interventions. Another project that I'm working on is philosophy of neuroimaging. I am working on a book that is exploring the epistemic aspects of neuroimaging, trying to answer the question of what it can and cannot tell us about the nature of mind and cognition. And one of the underlying problems is the problem that I call cognitive ontology, that is, what are the essential underlying elements of cognition? Finally, on the ethical realm, I'm interested in neuroethics, in particular neuroethical questions about neural intervention or brain interventions, as well as questions that arise in the context of disorders of consciousness. finally, although I'm not working actively on this right now, I have a standing interest in the relationship between neuroscience and philosophy of free will and responsibility, and in particular that the way that that informs or does or does not inform the law. So I've written a primer on criminal law and neuroscience with Stephen Morse, and I continue to be interested in the ways in which our legal system can be affected and informed by advances in neuroscience. So that kind of wraps up the things that I'm interested in. I'll put in a plug for an upcoming conference that I'm organizing at Pitt, at the Center for Philosophy of Science, and that is on the problem of cognitive ontology. So keep your eyes open for that, and it was nice to talk to you.